The Baltimore Ravens are on the clock, and this is a new era, Mel, because they have a new general manager. Yep. Ozzie Newsome is not there anymore.
It's Eric DaCosta, who's done a heck of a job for Ozzie Newsome over the years. They have a big need at wide receiver, and here's Hollywood Brown sitting there. They also have a big need for a center guard, a versatile kid like Eric McCoy from Texas A&M. I've been mocking him there all along, but if Marquise Brown is here, that's going to be the debate. I need to get the receiver. Remember, they had the tight ends in Mark Andrews, and now they hope a healthy Hayden Hurst this year. They need a receiver like Hollywood Brown. Eric McCoy, that's the debate. One of those two, I don't think you can go wrong with.
All right, we'll find out. Let's go to our draft expert, Todd McShay. Todd, what are you thinking and what are you hearing right now?
Yeah, Mel just mentioned wide receiver. We knew the wide receivers were going to fall. Marquise Brown right now, the number two player left on my board. Baltimore needs offensive line, but Baltimore needs playmakers and difference makers. So only 166 pounds. He's got the Liz Frank injury, but he's going to be ready for the season. I think the perfect fit right here would be Marquise Brown, and if he doesn't go at 25, I think 26 is a strong possibility to the Indianapolis Colts as well. So this wide receiver group starts with Marquise Brown. There's a lot of depth. We'll see a bunch of guys come off the board tomorrow, but Brown is the one receiver that I truly believe belongs in the first round.
All right, Todd, thanks. We'll see if that happens. And again, keep in mind, we're in the back third of the final quadrant of the draft, and the last time we didn't have a wide receiver taken in the first round was 2008. Mel, I know the only one you projected in your final mock was Marquise Brown, and you have him still at the top of the list.
Exactly. And I think if it hadn't been for the injury and wondering whether he'll be ready for training camp, he would have probably gone earlier. N'Keal Harry's hot. He's in that late first, early second round discussion. I'm actually at the Arizona Cardinals first pick in round two. Look at him to really provide some offensive production for Kyler Murray in that passing game. DK Metcalf had injuries two of the last 3 years, only 67 career catches, but he's a physically talented receiver. And his teammate A.J. Brown had a heck of a career. Then you got Deebo Samuel,
great slot catch. Receiver.
There's some good-looking receivers going to be in it. We said it'd be a great second-round receiver group, and that will be in a great second-round defensive back group, which it will be. Tune in tomorrow night. There's going to be some big-time players.
Well, Paris Campbell drafted. Might be drafted tomorrow night. Hakeem Butler, the
Miles
kid out of
Boykin,
Iowa State. Miles Boykin out of Notre Dame. A lot of potentially really, really good wide receivers. Okay, so we'll see what happens with the Ravens are doing again. They traded back for this pick. The Baltimore Ravens getting ready. Hey, buddy. Getting ready to pick the 25th overall selection. Hey, buddy. Let's go to Roger Goodell.
With the 25th pick in the 2019 NFL Draft, the Baltimore Ravens select Marquise Brown, wide receiver, Oklahoma.
So Baltimore is going to Hollywood. By the way, Marquise Brown is a fascinating story. He's cousins with Antonio Brown. He's never going to weigh more than 170, 175 pounds, but the kid can flat out fly. He was born 2 weeks early, as I said, cousin of Antonio Brown. He has the Liz Frank injury that he's having to deal with here, right?
Exactly, and that makes it questionable, obviously, for OTAs, for training camp. When will he be ready to go? The Ravens have not had good luck drafting wide receivers. That's the one position Ozzie Newsome kind of struggled at. The organization as a whole has struggled at.
Here's
the kid. You talk about dynamic. I call him a diminutive dynamo, Lewis and Booger. With the ball in his hands, he's electric. You got to keep him healthy, though. He has had some injuries at Oklahoma in terms of being able to have to go to the sidelines. But 166 pounds, will he ever be 175? We'll see. But if you can keep him on the field for Lamar Jackson, who's got to improve as a passer, this kid, I'll tell you what, what's underrated about him, he's tough.
If you look at how Baltimore is going to play, they're obviously going to run the football. Teams are going to bring 7 and 8 guys up, that extra guy in the box, to stop the run. What is that going to create? A lot of one-on-one opportunities on the outside. Lamar Jackson, can he hook up with Hollywood Brown?
Look, and here's the thing about Hollywood Brown. You need to get him the ball quickly. If you want to increase Lamar Jackson's completion percentage and the wide receivers and their yards after the catch per reception, get him the ball quickly. And that's one of the things you can do with him. You're seeing all these highlights of him just blowing past people down the field. But think about this. Think about the ways in which some of the more creative offenses use weapons like this. Put him in the backfield. Throw him bubble screens. Throw him rocket screens. Throw him swing passes. Get him the ball quickly. Get some blockers out in front of him. It doesn't always have to be 9 routes down the field, because this kid can do it all. Look, he, to me, is DeSean Jackson Jr. That's what he's like, okay? And I'm telling you, I know there's some people who are worried about his Liz Frank. From what I've been told, look, if you're not going to draft him because he's not going to be ready for OTAs in minicamp, then you're going to miss out on something in training camp in the regular season because he's electric.
Here's a bigger question. Do we think he can help Lamar Jackson? That's the bigger question. That's
what I'm saying. If you're just going to send him on nine routes and post corners and expect Lamar to be one of those guys who automatically just miraculously becomes a deep down the field outside the numbers passer, it's not going to happen.
Right. No.
You're going to have to be creative with how you use him.
Listen, well, this kid was creative in finding a way to play. All his offers fell through after his high school days, so he went to the College of the Canyons in L.A., and they couldn't pay for everything, so he got a job working the roller coasters at Six Flags Magic Mountain and Googled rooms for rent and found one, and his roller coaster salary allowed him to get by in the greater Los Angeles area.
You gotta hustle, baby.
Hey, listen, every day you gotta find a way.
You gotta hustle.